12:30, a crack appeared in silo 20. 45 minutes later, it collapsed. Expect serious load shedding, tweeted energy expert Professor Anton Eberhard.
In today's headline news, violence erupted in South Africa as police overreacted to employees lashing out against salary reductions imposed by mining and agricultural companies forced to deal with costly power interruptions.
Residents took to the streets to highlight their grievances. Their spiraling anger quickly turned violent. Foreign-owned shops bore the brunt.
Angry farm workers are not backing down. They want 150 rand a day. Their protest turned violent again amid reports of looting. Vineyards were set alight. A helicopter was used to douse flames. Police used rubber bullets to disperse workers.
Meanwhile, experts say there are constitutional challenges in deploying the army.
It's unsustainable.
Walter knows he's breaking the law and the risks that come with it. As an electrician for the Soweto Electricity Crisis Committee, he reconnects power to people who have been cut off. But what happens next is still a shock.
Bundled into the boot of an unmarked car by four men who aren't wearing any identification. The ringleader gets into a second car, marked Sticker, the electricity company that provides power to the residents of Soweto.
It is 1700 hours GMT here in Cairo. We've got alive in half an hour, but the lights went off. If it remains like this in the next half an hour, then we've lost the live for the show.
Despite being Africa's top oil producer and holding the world's ninth largest gas reserves, Nigeria's power output is a tenth of South Africa's for a population three times the size.
And promises of restructuring until the lights went out.
Another day, another disgruntled South African community, and another service delivery protest against the government.